this murder would be done, better it be done quickly. But I do fear we teach bloody instructions, which in being taught return to plague the inventor. This even-handed justice commends the ingredients of our poison chalice to our own lips. Will, what news?
He's almost finished his supper.
Has he called for me?
You knew he would.
We will go no further into this horrible business. The king hath honored me as of late.
Was the hope drunk wherein you dressed yourself? Hath it slept since? Would thy live a coward in thine own esteem?
Peace. I dare do all that I may to become a man. Who dare does more is none.
What beast was then that made you break this enterprise with me? When you durst do it, you were a man. And to be more than what you were, you would be so much more than man.
Suppose we fail.
We fail? Screw your courage to this sticking place, and we will not fail. When King Duncan is asleep, his two servants will I make drunk with wine. When they are asleep, what cannot you and I perform upon the unguarded Duncan? We'll then smear his blood on the two spongy officers and use their very daggers, and they shall bear the guilt.
Will it not be noticed that we are the ones that smeared the servants with blood?
Who will dare question us? We'll make our grief roar above his death. Come, Macbeth.
I'm settled. False face must hide what false heart doth know.
How goes the night, boy?
The moon is down. I've not heard the clock.
Here, take my sword. The heavy summons lies upon me, and yet I cannot sleep. Who's there?
A friend.
What, sir? Not yet at rest? The king's abed. He hath been in unusual pleasure. He has sent forth this diamond for your wife. Last night, I dreamt of the weird sisters. To you, they have shown some truth.
I think not of them.
Well, good repose a while.
The likes to you. Good night, sir. I go and it is done. The bell invites me. Hear it not, Duncan, for it is a knell that summons thee to heaven or to hell.
Guards!